Yeah, Future Voodoo Man here, and as I announced, you'll get a little bit of a montage of my future fails killing the throne defenders. And I didn't realize I have forgotten to pick up the stone ring. So I'm doing that right here, hoping that it will help. Future information, it didn't. Not really. So, yeah, I passed on that one. And here's my first of three further tries. I didn't put every single try in this one. I think some only lasted a few seconds because I was suffering, how do you say it, a degradation of skills because of frustration. Everybody knows this phenomenon. But I didn't give up and eventually I made it. So, death number one. And yeah, this fight is actually shorter than the other one. Yeah, I sped this up a little bit. Actually, there's nothing much to talk about how I fail to fight these guys. Yeah, at least it wasn't as bad as Shrine of Amana. So this is the try where I succeeded, and I didn't realize that I had the third Dragon Ring. It really helped. So I talked about the armor, I talked about how you're supposed to lure them to attack both at once. Not really easy sometimes. Sometimes they would just not attack for some reason. So yeah, this fight is actually a few minutes long. I'm surprised. Normally I win rather fast and lose rather fast, but this one I needed some patience to do it. So yeah, this was actually the one of only two cases, the first one being Shrine of Amana, where my patience was really tested. But yeah, still I think this challenge is very much doable by everyone, I think. If you don't succeed, you can still say it's possible. Here's the proof. Of course other people did it, but if this is the only only challenge you've seen so far and need some encouragement, here it is. So yeah, really that's not much to talk about. I'm thinking of a topic right now. By the way, I'm making this final episode extra long. It's kind of a tradition for me to make final episodes extra long. I've already had an episode like that with Shrine of Amana, but just because I didn't make much progress. And I'm just gonna cut off the credits at the end from my real final episode and make this episode like 40 minutes long. So it's not too long, but yeah, it's manageable. And yeah, we will talk about if I'm gonna make a DLCs. I'm gonna say that I will do that as a celebration for my for getting a new job, which I, by the way, I didn't get. I got an email yesterday, and yeah, standard answer for someone who didn't get it. Like there are so many very. How do you say it? Very. I don't even know how to say that, sorry. Very good applicants, and I wasn't one of them, and there were only small differences that might have had an impact on the decisions of the higher ups. So, the normal bullshit answer, and yeah, here I. This is the first time I see that the throne defender loses his shield. It's the first time I've seen that. Well, maybe that's because this is the first time I see them in any kind of post-commentary or footage that it was recorded and didn't took the time to look at it. Oh, that's an interesting detail. I've never realized that before. So I've been learning many, many interesting new facts about this game, so that's kinda awesome. So yeah, like I said, I'm not wearing the stone ring, and I could still stagger them at some points. And this is it, both are dead. So here you have it, it's possible, and past Voodoo Man will greet you now. Later! Hello everyone, welcome back to my Shield Only Challenge. So, wow, Throne Defenders. So, at least they were not as bad as Shrine of Amana, but still. I didn't realize I had the third Dragon Ring and did not pick up the Stone Ring. So first I thought trying out the Stone Ring to stagger these guys would be a good idea. So no, that didn't work as I planned, so I went with the third Dragon Ring. So, what I'm doing here. Now I'm going to level up my strength to 50, and I think it's time to work towards my end setup, meaning getting those two shields, as well as enough item capacity to fast roll still with these shields up. So I still need 4,000 souls, we can get that done for the next level up. So, before I'm going back to the crypt, I'm going to use... no, I'm not going to use anything. I am going to farm those two Red Phantoms in the Belfry Soul, I think it's called. Correct me if I get this wrong. Anyway, yeah, they have a chance to drop these shields. And maybe I can find an item or two that I will maybe need. Who knows? But other than that, I have no intentions of getting anything else. So yeah, I want to find out which setup is better for me against Nashandra and the Giant Lord. Or King, whatever. I don't know what he's called in English. So... yeah, we still need to get on that to that bonfire. So which one is the best way? This one or this one? I think this one. I'm glad I got this out of the way. I still have like I think 22 minutes to record this. I put the montage. Before this in the same episode, and I will do the post commentary later. So I don't know what I'm going to talk about at this point. I will let future Voodoo Man take care of past business. So yeah. About all the optional bosses. Maybe I'm going to do them in the post game after Nashandra. Not sure. I will consider the challenge done after I beat Nashandra. I'm not sure if I'm going to put this guy into New Game Plus yet. Since I haven't played the DLCs yet, I might consider doing them with the challenge build as well. Just because I think everybody has seen the DLCs from bigger channels with their normal setups. Unless you've already, unless you haven't already beaten the DLC them yourself, then what am I, what was I trying to say? I don't know, I forgot. Anyway, yeah, might consider doing DLCs with this one. Maybe blind, that would be interesting, but that will require some farming. Like human effigies, I think, will be very important. Because, well, who knows what they are good for in DLC. I don't know. So, I have many bonfire aesthetics, so I don't probably won't need them when I want to farm anything. What else? What else? Well, I can think about these things after I beat Nashandra. It's not like I miss anything after that. These guys are assholes. So yeah, if you want me, if you want me to do that, I will keep you up to date with my. With my purchases in terms of DLCs, but I can't tell if that's gonna happen in the near future. So, yeah, maybe if I'm getting my first payment from my new job. If I'm getting it, then I'll do that to celebrate. But. If I'm getting a new job, I'm probably not gonna have as much time for gaming and for videos anyway. So that's gonna be something special then. And it only fits that I do the challenge as being something special, blind. But yeah, you will see, we will see. So I will only try to fight the phantoms. I have no interest in anything else right now, and I'm going to wear my item discovery setup, meaning vendor's hat, and I think I've got, yeah, prisoner's tatters. Don't think we will need anything else. We don't have anything else item boosting, except, yeah, the gold serpent ring, and we still have 40 in weight, okay, percent in weight. So did you know that you can actually play baseball with the fire bombs? If you hit them in midair, you can actually deflect them like a Jedi, but it's hard to do. It's really hard to do, not gonna lie. Okay, I was wondering when this guy was going to show up. What's this weapon, by the way? I don't think I ever had it. One and... two, one, one more, come on, thanks. Never really fought him like this. Anyway, did you know that you can level up the Belfry, the Bell Guardian Covenant offline in this place? I already did the guide on about this one. I did it in German though. It's not hard to figure out what I'm saying. If you want me to explain that in English, just tell me. I have no problems in doing that again. I don't have the footage, but I could just download the footage from YouTube again. No problem. So, yeah. But I will have to mute the original video, I guess. Ow. One, two, three. Oh, that wasn't so bad. Did he drop anything? No. By the way, that helmet of his kind of reminded me of Shiva of the East. Did you see that? I might put a frame of this footage as a picture in this video. I don't know. Maybe. If I'm right, then I'll put it in there. If I'm just th seeing things, then you will know by not putting a picture of it in there that I was just completely wrong. One, two. Oh, come on. So these grays, no, not gray, these black phantoms, dark spirits, whatever, actually blue, just like the Dark Moon dudes from the first game. Just find this really weird that you can see the blue only from special angles. So yeah, we don't have many life gems left, so I'll probably have to be careful about that. But we only have two bosses in ahead of us that I will actually do. So I have no doubt that there will be enough. Only Nashandra is giving me a headache. Just because, yeah, her cursing that might get annoying. So, no, I don't think their helmets are anything like Shiva's. So that was just wild assumption right now. I'm just seeing things. Yeah. Okay. Black Phantom, I don't think it drops anything. And doesn't come after me, I think. Yeah. Return to its world. Okay, cool. So yeah, you can kill that guy by leveling up the Covenant here. Also, there is a rare spawn, of a rare spawn Phantom that has that Berserker Blade and the Mad Warrior set, I think. It also drops all this stuff. So for everyone who doesn't know, here is a fake wall, but it has nothing that is of any use for me, I think. Black Knight Greatsword. Actually, never used any Black Knight equipment. Protective Chime and Grand Spirit Tree Shield. So yeah, no luck here. So I will farm in the crypt, but I will level up if I don't have enough souls. I still have hard souls, no problem. No problem. So yeah, then the that two knights in the crypt will have to die many times probably. With my luck, I will just get two of the same shields in a row and never the counterpart. So we have enough strength now. Upgrade Estus Flask. I can't do that. No. I can't burn anything, so travel to the crypt. I hope I can kill them before all those weird hollows come after me. So ditch. Where is this? Where is this? This is what I need to go. Luckily, I've already killed all those weird Grim Reaper dudes. At least in my way. I hope these hollows are not coming after me. I think. Yeah, that one. Oh! Forgot about that one. So, yeah, that's pretty much what I'm going to do the next few hours probably. I will also need to upgrade my stuff. So, yeah. Probably need to be careful with these guys. That they don't attack me while I'm still in attack animation. I actually li like how they look. I sh should have probably just farmed for their set instead. Ouch. It was a draw, damage-wise. Whoa! How did that happen? Come on. One down. One to go. So yeah, if I'm done with these, with this guy, I'll just make a cut. I don't care how long the episode is going to be this time. Maybe I'll just put an update about my farming on the rest of it. I don't know. Okay, no job. Sen. Sen. How stereotypical could I get? No. Okay, then I'll just use the feather and yeah, see you in the next episode. Thanks for watching. Later. Hey, so the worst case scenario seems to have happened. Looks like I've killed all the possible spawns of these guys and I didn't get one shield out of it. So, yeah, at least I got two helmets. Don't think I got one armor out of it. No, not one. Imperious gloves, that's one. No, two. Imperious gloves, and I might have, yeah, the leggings, so the armor is missing. Yeah, so it looks like I won't have my wished setup for the Giant Lord and Nashendra. However, if somebody can fetch these things for me and give them to me via co-op, that would be really awesome. So maybe I'm going to use that setup in a New Game Plus game, so I can show you guys. So yeah, let's wait for that, and yeah, see you guys in the next episode where I'm trying to get to the Giant Lord. Later! Yeah, welcome back to my shield-only challenge. Looks like winter is coming for the Giants. So yeah, I don't think I'm gonna go straight ahead for the Giant Lord. And I will just look for other things I might need in other memories. So let's just do that. Let's just do that. Yeah, we are starting in the Cardinal Tower. And yeah, let's just go with the flow. So yeah, since I'm going to do King Vendrick, at least in the post game, maybe I should gather all the giant souls. Couldn't do any harm to me anyway. So yeah, big bummer about that, about those two shields. But what can you do? What can you do? Since for the challenge I didn't allow co-op. I won't be able to use them at all for the rest of the challenge, or for the rest of the playthrough.
What
Oh, and
that
yeah, that's pretty much how it is. So,
begone.
looks like we are going to use this one shield ever from the point we got it to the end, and that's actually pretty cool. I mean, when do you get some kind of equipment and use that for the rest of the game? Okay, I pulled that off with the warrior set in Dark Souls 1 and the longsword. I actually like the longsword. it has a great moveset and a decent scaling, so what else do you need? Yeah, big problem are the giants here, of course. I will have to kill one of those giants that I don't like. Oh, I'm burning. No, no, no. That was a close one. So, yeah, I'm just going to fetch that item if I can. Maybe those pyromancers know they're still there. Let's just take this. Bonfire aesthetic. Mm. Don't really need it, but who knows? Maybe later. So yeah, not sure if we need to kill that one giant or if we can get the soul. Maybe we can trick him. Don't think we have to kill him. In the one of the chests is I think a shield, but I don't plan on using that anyway. So soul of a great hero. Yes. Okay, that's all we need. Let's get out of this place. So yeah, I think when they announced this game, they also said there will be some kind of time travel, and this is maybe this is what they talked about, or maybe they talked about the DLC that wasn't planned out at that point. Who knows? Oh, I should have rested probably. Oh, doesn't matter. So yeah, I was kind of disappointed when this was only a real short fraction of the game. I hope for some kind of backtracking into Lordran and stuff. Maybe see a little bit more lore like in Artorias of the Abyss DLC. But yeah, didn't really happen. I don't care. Doesn't matter to me anymore. I mean, all in all, this game is really good, but it could have used some, how do you say it, fine-tuning, lore-wise, and PvE combat is great. I haven't heard that many good things about, the PvP, but I'm not actually a PvP player, so I don't really care. Yeah, that's pretty much it. So, the giant, that's all we need. Let's get out of this place. So, King Vendrick. Are we gonna fight him before Chandra? Let's just do all the optional bosses in the post-game. So where do we get one last soul? Don't really remember. Ah. We need to equip the King's Ring. So, yeah. Where's the one last soul? I'm not gonna fight the ancient dragon, that's for sure. Don't remember. Maybe I already have one. No, it's the two giants which dropped the key to the Pilgrims of Dark. So no, I'm not gonna fight Gwyn. Gwyn. He's similar to Gwyn, kinda, but no. Not gonna fight Vendrick. Because with only two giant souls, he is pretty much impossible. Maybe not impossible, but I don't have the patience for that. I wouldn't even have the patience even if I fought him normally, with normal gear. So, yeah, sucks, but nope, not gonna happen. Sorry. If you can fight him, if you can get more giant souls by burning a bonfire aesthetic, please tell me, I don't know. So this is what I heard at the beginning of the game. When I first started the game, I thought, there might be a Titanite lizard nearby. So that got me fooled. Twinkling Titanite 2, that's awesome. Maybe later. So for Nashandra, I think I'm gonna fetch myself some cursed resistance gear. I don't think her attacks are actually very dangerous to me, except maybe that explosion and the melee attacks should be very much avoidable. So, yes, sorry, Captain Drummond, but you are not going to help me this time. He never helped me. I always summoned Bernard. Ow. Okay, follow me some more. Did I kill them all? No. So yeah, this is actually the place you take for the ranged attacks, but nope, not going to happen this time. So what I'm going to do is aim for his feet, of course, and if he lifts a foot, I'll just run for the other. And you can actually tank this guy, if you do it right. Okay, something killed the other giant. He probably went back to his place in the very beginning. Ow. No, that's not how you block this guy. Memo to myself, don't look at his feet when he goes for a swing. Memo to myself, of course. He isn't actually that hard, I think. Last time, like I said, I tried Silvermon's dual-wielding club build, sorry, and it wasn't so bad, really effective, I must say. So I'm awaiting the first fire. Come on, thanks, and run like hell. Run like you never ran before. Run, forest. Any other things I should mention? I don't know. I don't care. Yeah, you can actually tank him. That's awesome. Every time I say it, he hits me. Ow. Yeah, the real problem is with just huge enemies is that, yeah, you can't see shit when you melee them. That's the only gripe I have with big enemies. I have no problem with fighting big enemies in general, but it's really a thing of boss design, because if you can't see what they are doing, it sucks. I hate to guess these things. So yeah, keep moving, and he shouldn't hit you. So wait for the stamina to come back. Ow. Come on, take a swing. Thanks. Yeah, you can actually lure him to do certain attacks. Whoa, that hit me. That sucks. Oops, no, I didn't want to attack. I wanted to do this. Come on, take a swing. So yeah, this is a bad position. This was a wild guess. Ow. What? What? Oh, come on. This wasn't fair. You have to admit, that wasn't fair. That attack was done. And I rolled into it. Once again, like I said, he isn't so hard. Even now, maybe this death could have been avoided. Maybe I should have just rolled the other way, but yeah, it sucks. I thought since he doesn't do any kind of area effect or something, like a spell after that, I thought you could just roll into it. But no. Not that easy. So they are already done with their enemies, so this sucks. See, I rolled into this attack, but it didn't do anything. One, two. Swing? Yes. Well, nope. Too far away. Swing, no. One, two, swing. Ow, hit me. Oh, wrong item. Swing? No. But now he swings. No. One, two, now he swings. One. Come on, swing at me, or I'll swing at you. See? Not too hard, but yeah. So we got the Giant's Kinship, and the path to Nashendra is free. So where do we get the curse resistance ring? I don't remember. See, it's this little these little details I just don't seem to remember. Curse resistance. No, it's whatever. Maybe we can kill her without it. But first we are going to level up. We have enough item burden thanks to our rings. So I will just level up some vitality? No. Some endurance. No, adaptability is probably better right now. It has a soft cap. I think agility with 101. So I could put some more points into there. I think that's the hard cap is. Soft cap, I mean. What do we need? 2,500 souls. Yeah, we can do that. So. Yes, and these are worth, I think, 50 souls. Yes. I hope this is enough. If not, no, I'll burn two more of these. This should be enough. Like I said, I hope these tiny tiny souls had some kind of use, but nope, they don't. What do we have now? Not more agility. Okay. So yeah, let's try Nashendra. It's not like I have anything else to do for the challenge. Smelter Demon and Bell Gargoyles will have to wait till the end. Of course, it's not as exciting as when I did them, when I had the chance first, but really, I like the Fallen Sinner, the Lost Sinner, better with the Darkness. Don't ask me why, I just like it better. Not so much for New Game Plus, because there are these stupid ads, but yeah, pretty much. So now I will put some... put that away. Let's make not so much of a mess in here. I will put some other items in here. I'll put a human effigy in here. Just because when I drop like 33% under my maximum health, I just don't like fighting like that, and I would just use a human effigy.
My journey is already complete. My name is Shanalot. The dragon gave me this name, for I was born with none. I was born of dragons, contrived by men. By ones who would cozen fate herself. They are the ones who created me. But they failed. I did not come out as intended. Fate would not be bested, and men were cursed once again. If you proceed, Nashandra will come after you. Knowing that you will take the throne and link the fire. She covets the first flame and the great soul. Put Nashandra to rest.
Yes, ma'am. By the way, I've heard she had two different colored eyes. Let's see if we can see that. Ah! No. No, no, no. Estus? Estus. Thanks. So, let's see. Casey Brown and blue. See that? So, she just covers her one eye because it doesn't look human. That's interesting. That's very interesting. By the way, she said something like, and humans were cursed again, so... did the undead curse return because somebody wanted to change their fate again? I can't say. Maybe. So, yeah. But I don't think the undead curse is actually triggered by something. Don't really like that idea. But, yeah, we don't know. The first time in Lordran, it was caused because the first flame was fading, and mankind returned to its original state, hollow. So, maybe it's a metaphor that all flames will die one day, and all humans will die one day. Everything dies one day, except. The Everlasting Dragons. Of course.
Brave undead. You have proven yourself to me. Now, be one with the dark.
Yeah, yeah, eventually we will. So I hope we can actually hit these things. Oh, we are cursed pretty quickly. So, yeah. Cursed again. So, come on. Yeah, like I said, actually you only have to dodge her attacks properly, and that shouldn't be too hard if you kill the spheres first. What are you doing? You always do it the same. One, two, that's it. That's the explosion, I think. No. Let's get away. Drink cactus juice. Whoa! I didn't know she could do that. First time seeing that. That's interesting. Always learning something new. So I hope... Yep, she's not in range of these spheres, so maybe I can lure them just away. Her, just away. Heal, thanks. So yeah, next... Oh, away, 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 away. Human effigy. And here when I can. Come on. Are there actually gonna be more spheres the longer the fight gets? No. Doesn't look like it. One. Two. Yeah, I should probably just trigger her beam attack and then run at her if possible. Her mid-range and far-range attacks aren't too bad. I think her explosion is actually instant death. I don't know. Maybe, maybe not. Come on. Stamina, return to me. So she should summon some more spheres now. Yes. First try and boss, what a disappointment. Soul of Nashandra. So, yeah. Whew, end of the challenge. Like I said, I will keep the optional bosses for the post-game. And I will consider this challenge a success. It's definitely possible for everyone. I mean, I could do it, you can do it. It's actually not... that bad, so everyone, I will hereby encourage you again to try this, and your skill can actually only grow, so you will see, once you started, it's not that different from your original playstyle, at least it wasn't for mine. So, thanks for watching, I hope you watched this from the very beginning. Leave comments, likes, tell others about this, or rather, ask others to try this, and yeah, see you next time. Maybe I will try something else later.
You who link the fire. You who bear the curse. Once the fire is linked, souls will flourish anew, and all of this will play out again. It is your choice to embrace or renounce this. Great Sovereign, take your throne. What lies ahead, only you can see.